How's it going, everyone? This is Scott Sakai, and today I wanted to share with you guys a story about the most infuriating client experience I've ever had and what I learned from it. So this client was a referral from another client that I worked with at the time. And these guys were both business partners together. And to make this easier to follow along with, I'm gonna call the hell client Kim. So Kim wanted me to shoot a comedy sketch and a teaser video for a product that he was currently putting together an Indiegogo campaign for. And I was pretty excited because he was giving me a decent budget to work with, and I saw it as an opportunity to produce something that was bigger than anything I had produced at the time. So I did everything I needed to do. My producer and I wrote out a script and the client approved it. We casted actors, I got the production crew together, found a location, handled the rentals, and the production went as smooth as it possibly could have. Until I showed Kim the first cut. He emailed me back asking if we can have a meeting to discuss the changes, and I'm asking him to send me the notes over email, but he keeps strongly insisting that I meet with him in person. I show up to this meeting, and instead of giving me constructive criticism and focusing on the things that he needed fixed, he spends the next hour degrading me in front of everybody, telling me how terrible of a job I've done, the video was late, and that I needed to fix the things that I screwed up. Lesson number one that I learned from all of this: you need to communicate deadlines before production actually starts. We actually never agreed on a due date, and I even told him that, but he turned it around on me, saying that I was supposed to have everything done in a week when I originally told him that I would have a first draft done for him in a week. And then he started telling me about how I screwed everything up, so I asked him, what exactly did I screw up on? And his response was that the teaser video didn't have enough information about the product, and that I wasn't using white actors, and that the text didn't look visually appealing enough. And to provide context to this, when he originally talked about making a teaser video, he was extremely vague about what he wanted. He went from saying the teaser was a recap of the comedy sketch to being a trailer of the comedy sketch to a video that explains the features of the product in a less comedic way to being a low priority video. And when I was discussing with him additional costs for that video, he said that since it's a low priority video, to not worry about it and just edit it out of the comedy sketch footage. So I didn't accommodate extra budget for that video. Huge mistake. And the reason why he didn't like the fact that I didn't use white actors, and I know what you're thinking, it's not because of racism, it's because it's a company that was based out of an Asian country. So when Asian companies are trying to market their products in America, it's really important to them that the actors in the videos are American, because American faces gives customers the impression that it's a product made in America. Something to keep in mind when you're watching commercials. So since it was a low priority video and I didn't put enough resources into it because I was basically told that I didn't have to, it ended up being the thing that burned me the most, because it eventually got turned around on me and became the most important video of the two. So again, communication, it's extremely important on both sides. So he wanted me to do reshoots, and I told him that if I have to reshoot anything, then it's going to cost extra. And his response was, I'm not gonna pay you for your fuck ups. And I didn't want to be the guy that was arguing back and escalating the situation, so I tried my best to accommodate him in a way that worked out for both of us. And his response was, there is no other way. You either do what I ask or we drop the whole project. And I was this close to just telling him to drop the whole project at that point. But what made me change my mind was that I really liked working with the client who originally referred me. And I knew that he had investments into Kim's company. So me dropping the project meant that the client I liked working with was going to get burned too. Since he was somebody that treated me respectfully and someone who regularly hired me, I decided to work with Kim to try to salvage the work as much as possible without doing reshoots. So at this point, I'm mentally exhausted from the amount of time that I've had to spend putting up with this person, but I was determined to finish the project and leave a good impression on the client that I liked working with. So I ended up going to Kim's office and editing it with him so that he knew what he was getting. More arguments come up while we're working together about disagreements on the edit, and I try explaining to him from a video perspective why I thought it was important to have certain things be shown and not shown, and his employees agreed with me. But because it wasn't his idea, he completely disagreed and continued to just mock us, because apparently we had no idea what we were talking about. We hired a voiceover person to narrate the important parts of the video, and while I was recording the voiceover, just to cover my ass, ass because at this point, any coverage counts. I had him say it in different speeds multiple times, slow, normal, and fast, just so I knew for sure that no matter what happened, it was possible to make this voiceover work. And sure enough, Kim comes in and tells me that the voiceover isn't going to work because it may not fill the time that was necessary to fill. But since I covered my ass this time, I assured him that we have exactly what we need, and he still had the nerve to tell me that it's not going to work. Luckily, I convinced him once I actually showed him the voiceover edited in. So after 3 long, emotionally draining editing sessions, I finally finished the videos to his liking and he finally paid me. And when I got that check, I couldn't help but feel really, really stupid because the amount I ended up paying myself wasn't worth the time and energy invested into it. This was like 2 months worth of work for $1,000. That was really stupid of me. Despite how miserable I felt during the process of this project, I wouldn't want to have experienced it any other way. Even though I cringe at the video and wish that it didn't exist, I walked away from it a much better filmmaker. Difficult clients teach you a lot more than the easygoing ones will. So the main things that I learned from this whole ordeal was that you need to have a ton of communication on a project. If a client is vague or isn't explaining things well, don't be afraid to just keep asking question after question. It may be annoying on their end, but it beats having to fix mistakes later because of poor communication. No matter how properly you do things, they can still go wrong. You don't have any real control over how a client communicates or how they look at a situation. There are going to be times where you have to work with egomaniacs, and these people have a tendency to always shift the blame to other things or power trip over you. I always try to be reasonable with him, even when I didn't want to, and he always continued to show how big his corporate dick is. If you are being mistreated by a client, don't be afraid to walk away because your mental sanity is much more important than your paycheck. And lastly, I learned that I needed to charge more. When you charge too little, yes, you may increase the likelihood of booking the project, but you never know when the client is going to be extremely difficult to work with or if the project ends up taking longer than you originally anticipated. Charging more will allow you to have more resources when needed, make it more tolerable to deal with a difficult client, and overall just helps you grow as a creative. So that's the video for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the story and I really appreciate you watching the video. There's thousands of YouTube videos online and the fact that you watch mine means a lot to me. And if you want to see more from me, my social media links are in the description below and check out the rest of my YouTube channel for more videos from me. Have an amazing day and I'll see you guys later. Peace.